Morning, everybody. So today we are going to discuss about our next experiment, that is sequence detector. So when come to theory, we studied about what is the meaning of a sequence detector. The same example I'm going to take it to here. So here I'm going to take one sequence. If it is detected, then I'm going to get my output as 1. Else we are taken as a 0. For that, we are going to design one digital circuit. Let's move on to the aim of our experiment. The aim of the experiment, you can write it out. So, design and implement a sequence detector, that is 3-bit sequence detector, using Moore model and D flip-flop. So, I want to design one digital circuit for the sequence detector, that to 3 bits, and using the Moore model you need to take, and D flip-flop we are going to use. Okay. So, let's move on to the concept. So, steps for the sequence detector. You already know the different steps we are going to use. One, it is state diagram for the sequence detector. Second thing, it is find a number of flip-flops. Third one, it is state assignments. Fourth one, it is state table. Fifth one, it is simplify using KMAP. Sixth one, circuit design. Let's move on to the steps one by one. The first step, it is state diagram for a sequence detector. Should know that how to write the state diagram for a sequence detector. Okay, so here for an explanation purpose, I'm going to take in a sequence here. It is 101. Remember, the sequence they are given, it is 101. I'm going to do the construction for this. See, first you just identify in this given sequence, what is the LSB value. You can see that here it is 1 is my LSB. Second thing, we need to identify number of states for these bits. Remember, if it is a Moore model, means if it is having a n number of bits and it has n plus 1 states. Mealy model means n number of bits having n states. Now it is because of Moore model, here it is having 3 bits, so then I can use 3 plus 1, 4 states I need to use. Here I am going to take my 4 states as S0, S1, S2, S3. These are my 4 states. And so first state, I'm going to take an, it's an initial state, and this is happen at the reset condition also. Whenever it is reset my circuit, I'm going to consider my circuit should be there in this state only. So what I'm going to do? So how to write the first state, initial state? Remember, if my LSB bit is 1 is there, you consider 0 as my initial state. Suppose if my LSB bit it is 0 is there, then you need to take initial state as 1. This is a small changes. Okay. So in this case, what I'm going to take, the 1 is there. That's why initial state value I'm going to take as a 0. Okay. Then if first bit it is detected, then that state I'm going to take as 1. Next, 1, 0 it is detected. I'm moving from here to here. 1, 0 it is detected. Then I'm going to take it as S2. Next, 1, 0, 1. All 3 states are detected. Then I'm going to take it here. It is S3. So S0 means 0. S1 means 1. S2 means 1, 0. S3 means it is 1, 0, 1. Once you take these states, then next I want to do the next state values from this present state values. So how to do this? Just you take these values here and here. I'll take 0 and 0. See, here my S0 or S1 or S2 or S3. So having changes based on my input value. That is X is my input. So based on X input, it will be changes. Means based on the next bit. So here it is X value continuously for each state having the 2 options. Either the value is 0 or 1. That's why I'm going to consider for each state 2 bits. One it is 0, another one it is 1. So for that, I'll take 0, 1. Similarly, I have a state, S1 state, it will come to 1 is there. You just write 1, 1 here. Next, you have a 2 option, that is X input I'm going to take in here. If X value here it is 0 or 1. Similarly, 1, 0, 1, 0 I'm going to take in. Next, you have a 2 options to me. Either X value it is 0 or 1. Similarly, 101 already having these values I'm going to considering, and next I have options of 0 or 1. So based on this x value, some transition need to be takes place from present state to the next state. This is I'm going to taken as my present state, and next state I'm going to write it here. What is my next state value? It will come. Just see that. You just see that here my states, whatever the changes you do based on x, I need to present either at S0, S1, S2, S3 only. No other options to me. Then you just see that. You just completely read first. 0, 0. Anywhere you have 0, 0? No. There is no 0, 0. Then you cancel the first MSV bit. So I'm going to cancel this bit. Next, you have a 0? Yes, I have a 0. Then what is the state you have for 0, S0? Just write here it is S0. Okay, next I'll go for the second value 01. Anywhere you have a 01, so here there is no 01. This is 10, it is not a 01. So I'll go for all the cases. No, then I'll cancel the first MSV bit. Then you have a 1. So where is my 1? Yes, this is S1. The state value of 1, it is S1. Then I'll write the state, it is S1. Similarly, you just try for remaining cases. So what I'll do in the third case, S1, it is my present state. Now you have an option for 0. Anyway, you have a 10, just check it out. Yes, 10 is there. It is the state value of my S2. Then I'm going to write here it is directly, it is S2. Next, you check it for 11. Anywhere here is there? No. Then cancel MSV bit. So I'm going to cancel this bit. Next, you have a 1. Yes, 1 value here it is. S1 you have. Then directly I will write the value, it is S1. Similarly, just fill this 100 anywhere is there? No. Then cancel the first bit. Next, 00 anywhere is there? No. Then I'll cancel this bit. Only 0 is there? Yes. In this 4 only you need to check. Okay. So 0 is there? Yes. S0 state. Just write here it is S0. Similarly, you check for 101. Yeah. 101. I'll take the 101. You can see that 101, it is a state, it is S3. Directly you can take it is a S3. Similarly, next value it is 1010. Anywhere 1010, no chance at all because maximum it is 3 only. Then cancel the first bit. So 010 is there? No. Then cancel the next bit. Next, 10 is there? Yes, 10 is nothing but my S2 value. Directly I can take the value, it is S2. Clear. Next, last condition, 1011, it's not there, then cancel the first bit. 011 also, it is not there in the four combinations. Then I'll cancel the next bit also. 11, it's also not there. Then I'll cancel this bit. Finally, I have a 1. 1 means I have a S1. Just you write the value, it is S1. Clear. So once you write this, then it is understanding purpose, I explain this. Next, you need to write. Actually, you can write directly. But if you understand this concept, then easily you can write the state diagram. Let's move to the state diagram. What is the initial state I'm going to take on? S0. So this is my S0. So based on this S0 value, it is 0. So you see that S0 value, it is 0. Then it will go to S0. S0 value, it is 1. It will go to S1. Similarly, S1 value, it is 0. It will go to S2. S1 value, it is 1. Then it will go for S1. The red color are indication of my x. Based on this input, some changes is happening now. Okay, so let's move on to that. How to write the state diagram for that. First, you write S0. S0, you need to write in the circle and you need to mention S0 state. Okay, that is the present state right now. If value it is 0, you need to stay here only. See? S0 value, it is 0. You need to stay here only. That is S0. Next, if the value it is 1, or before going to that, I already told that if reset also, you need to present here only. Next, if the value it is 1, then you need to move from S0 to S1. So it is moving from S0 to S1. See that? If the value it is 1, it is moving from S0 to S1. Clear? Next, I'll go for the next condition. In the next condition, S1, it is my present state. First, I'll go for S1. The condition value, it is 0. Then I'm going to looking for S2. S1 value, if it is 0, then you need to move to S2. So that's why if it is 0, I need to move to S2. Another state. Otherwise, S1 value, if it is 1, where do I need to go? S1. So I'll write if it is 1, it will go back to S1 because I'm looking from S1 state only. If 0, it will go for S2, or in this condition 1 means you need to stay here only, don't do anything. Okay, next I'll go for an S2 condition. In the S2 condition, if it is 0, then it'll go for S0. So S2, the value it is 0, you need to go back to S0. And similarly, S2, the value, suppose if it is 1, you need to go to S3. You see that? I'll go for next state, that is S3. You can see that? If it is S3 is there, value it is 1, you need to go to S3. Similarly, S3 value, if it is 0 is there, then you need to go to S2. And before going to that, okay, 1 and 0 I have taken. Okay, S3, 0 means S2. S3, 0 means S2. Similarly, S3, 1 means it will go to S1. So based on this condition, I am going to write my table. So this is a state diagram of your 101 sequence detector. Okay, once you got this, the next step is very easy. Second step, okay, and before going to that, so I want to write the output also. That is very, very important. See that if I have a stream of bits, in the stream of bits, if my output it is detected, output is nothing but what my complete sequence should be getting. Okay, so next, once you got, next you can see that outputs I want to write. See, my sequence it is 101. So 101 is detected only at the S3. In the S3, if it is detected, then only output it is 1. Remaining S0, S1, S2. See, S0 it is 0. It is not my sequence. So definitely output it is 0 only. So when come to S1, only 1 bit is detected. Then output here it also it is 0 only. And S2, 2 bits are detecting. 10 is there. It is not my output. Output is 0 only. When come to S3, you have a 101. Then output it is 1. So in this case only, I'll get my output it is 1. So that's why S0 value is 0. S1 value it is 0 and S2 value it is 0, S3 value only it is 1. Because of this is a more module, so I'm going to represent it, my outputs inside the circle. Suppose if it is Mealy module, means we are going to represent it inside the arc, on that arc. Okay, so I represented, this is a state diagram of your sequence detector of 101. Once you got this, the next step I want to find out the number of flip-flops. Here you can see that number of states, how many states you got? 4 states, S0, S1, S2, S3. You just substitute the value, number of states here it is 4, should be it is greater than or equal to 2 to the power of n. N it indicates number of flip-flop. I want to find out number of flip-flops now, and they are telling it's in a D flip-flop. So number of flip-flop I want to find out. So n you need to find out. You just take this formula, 2 to the power of n should be greater than or equal to 4. Just you substitute the value, n is equal to 1, means is it possible to construct from one flip-flop? Just check it out. So 2 to the power of 1 is nothing but here it is 2, 2 greater than or equal to 4. This is a condition, it is not satisfied, then it is not possible from one flip-flop. Then what is the option I have? I'll go for n value, it is 2. If you have a n value, it is 2, then I'll have a 2 to the power of 2. 2 to the power of 2 is nothing but what? 4. 4 it is greater than equal to 4. Then equal condition it is satisfying. Then definitely I can use n is equal to 2. Nothing but number of flip-flops I need to use. 2 flip-flop. The 2 flip-flop I am going to take is a D flip-flop. And these 2 D flip-flops inputs I am going to take has in this case D2 as well as D1. And outputs I am going to take has Q2 as well as Q1 are present state outputs, and Q2 plus 1, remember Q2 plus, okay, otherwise plus only, I'll take Q1 plus are taken as a next outputs. Okay, so these are all the things I'm going to consider. So first you need to find out 2 flip-flop it's required to construct the circuit. Okay, next, third step, I want to do the state assignment. See, I want to assign some values to my states. So S0, it is coding, encoding, it is called state assignment or encoding. So here, how I want to do this process? Generally, I'm going to use this formula, n is equal to log 2 m. According to this, we have a 4 state S0, S1, S2, S3. Then m is indicates the number of state. Then you substitute the value of here, 4 states we have S0, S1, S2, S3. Then easily, Okay, so just substitute the value here, it is 4. Then you can find out of n means each state how many bits I need to represent. That is very important thing. So according to the approximately, you'll get the value here, it is 2. Then you can find out each state I need to represent it by 2 bits. Otherwise, directly you can consider if it is 4 states is there, then you can use a 2 bits for this. You know the combination of 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1 you can use. For example, if you have a 8 states means you can use 3 bits, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 up to 1, 1, 1 you can use. Okay, so here I'm going to considering my S0 as 0, 0, S1 as 0, 1, S2 as 1, 0, S3 as 1, 1. Clear? So once you got this value, next I'll go for, I want to fill the table. See that first you just write this table. States, present state, I already told the two flip-flop I'm going to use Q2 and Q1. And Q2 plus and Q1 plus based on my X value need to be changed from present state to the next state. Y is my output. D1 and D0 are the inputs of my flip-flops. First, how many states you have? 4 states. S0, S1, S2, S3. 4 states. And I already told that S0 is assigned as 0, 0. Then you just fill the values are 0, 0 here. Next, S1 value it is 0, 1. Then you just fill the value it is 0, 1. S2 value it is 1, 0, then you fill the value it is 1, 0. S3 value it is 1, 1, then you just fill the values it is 1, 1. Just fill these values. Next task it is, based on my input it is changes from present state to the next state. So you can see that every state having two options 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, just fill the values of 0, 1. We'll check it out the conditions. Okay. So once you got the 0101, you can see that S0, if the value it is 0, from the S0 value it is 0 means you need to stay here only, right? Then S0 value should become to S0 only, means S0 the value it is 00, you need to have a 00, just fill the value it is 00. Next, S0 value if it is 1 means where it is moving, S1, S1 coded as what? 01, just you write here it is 01. Similarly, from S1, if it is 0, then it will come to S2. S2 value it is 1, 0. Then you write it is 1, 0. Okay. Then S1 from S1 state. I'm looking from here. If it is 0, you can go for that. 1 means you need to stay here only, right? This one. You need to stay here only. Then I'm going to take an S1 value. S1 means I'll take it as in a 0, 1. Similarly, S2. S2 value 0, where it is going? Yeah, this is the arc. S2 value 0 means it is going to S0. S0 value here it is 0, 0, just fill the value it is 0, 0. Okay, so next, so 0, 0. Similarly, just fill that 1, 0. Where is my 1, 0? So 1, 0, yeah, I'll take the 1, 0. So 1, 0, it is S2 if it is 1. So this is a S2 state. If it is 1, then where it is S3. S3 means it is 1, 1. Just you write here it is 1, 1. Similarly, from 1, 1, if it is 0, go to S2. S2 value it is 1, 0. Just fill the value it is 1, 0. Okay. Next it is 1, 1. It is 1 means I'll get the value here. It is S1. S1 is nothing but what is the value I'll get? 0, 1. So similarly, just fill this. And outputs all the cases, you have a 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Only these cases it is 1, 1. Just fill the values. So I'll get the value here. It is this one. So just fill the value it is 1, 1. Next, I want to write D2 and D1. So one thing you remember, if it is the D1 and D2, it is how we are going to do. You already know the excitation table. You have a present state. This is my present state Q2 value. And you just see the Q2 plus values. And by seeing these two, with the help of excitation table, you can write D2. Similarly, Q1 and Q1 plus, you just see and you can write D1. I'm going to use a different flip-flops. But here I'm going to use a D flip-flop. And what is the advantages to me if I'm going to use a D flip-flop? So here it is next state output and D2 are same. Sorry, flip-flop inputs both are same. Because D flip-flop inputs and outputs are same thing. It's a data flow flip-flop. Then directly what are the values you have? 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. So just you can copy to here. 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. Only for the D flip-flop. Other flip-flop, please do this, just compare and you can write. Okay, next, when come to here it is Q1 plus it will come to copy to, just directly can copy to here D1, that values only. Okay, here I'm going to use the D flip-flop, just I'm copying this. Clear? Otherwise, use the excitation table. If you want to do excitation table, also you'll get the same values only. Okay. Once you did this one, next you need to simplify using the K map. Just do the simplification using the K maps. I did a simplification using the K map. So just check it out. So how I'm going to use? I'll take a Q2, Q1, X are my inputs. You write here it is Q2, Q1 and X. First, I'm going to solve for D2. Just D2. Next, Q2 having two options, 0 and 1. And Q1 of X means 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. First, I'm going to enter these four values, 0, 0, 1, 0. How? See that 0, 0, this is 1 and it will come back to 0. Next, 0, 1, 1, 0. 0, 1, this is 1 and 0. Next, do the grouping process and you need to simplify. How to do this? Just 1, 0 is there. Just, okay, 1, 1, just grouping this one. There is no other options to me. I'll group this one. It will come to a dual. So now you can see that 1, 0 is there. 1, 0 is nothing but row wise both the values are changing. Only column I'll get Q1 as well as X because of 0, I'll get Q1 X bar. And when come to here, there is no other grouping. So it is not possible group with anything. So then I can singly I'm going to grouping and I'll get the value. Here it is Q2, Q1 bar and X. You can see that Q1 value 0, X directly I'll get it out. And because of Q2 value, it is 1, I'll get Q2, Q1 bar, X. This is a D2 value. Similarly, you take for D1, same input variable only you take, Q2, Q1 and X. So Q2, Q1 and X, I'm going to use. And here, you can see that row values, both are, it is changing. And you'll get the values of column wise. So column wise, you have a 1, 1, and I'm doing the quad here. So for that quad, X value, common term is it is 1. So 1 means I'll get the X. So D1 is equal to X. Clear? So next, I'll take my Y value. You just solve for Y. So I have a 4 bits. I'll use a 4 bits now. 0, 0, 0 and 0. Next it is 0, 0, 1, 1. I can use 0, 0, 1, 1. If you take this one and you can simplify. So it is only one row I'll get from this. This is a Q2. So Q2 I'll write here and common term here, first bit it is common, this 1 and 1. So 1 for Q1, then directly I can take it as a Q2 and Q1. So there the normal KMF simplification, you do that and you'll get the values of D2, D1 and Y. Once you got this, then you need to construct the circuit diagram. That is the main intention. Okay, so how to construct the circuit? Let's move on to that. If these are the values I have, D2, D1 and Y. So first you need to write D flip-flops. So I'm going to write the D flip-flops right now. So just you write the D flip-flop. So 1 and second D flip-flop I'm going to take on here. And what I'm going to do, I'll take the values here. It is D1. This is my Q1. And you can take it as a Q1. Bar. Similarly, here you take the D2, this is my Q2 and this is taken as a Q2 bar. So once you take, next you take the clock signal. You can take active high or active low, but in the practically looking for a negative edge or active low conditions only, just I'll take this one. This is my clock and this is my clock signal I'm going to take on. Just I'm going to use a clock. Next, I want to do the D1 first. I'll take the input D1, it is X directly I can take. So X is my input. Directly, I can connect one line here. Okay. So next, once you got these conditions, next you can see here. Next, I'm going to looking for an D2. The D2 is my input. So D2 is nothing but first I'll get Q1 and X bar. I want the X bar. In order to get the X bar, just I'll tap here. I'm going to use one NOT gate. So NOT gate I'm going to use. So NOT gate output, it is, I'll get here, it is X bar. Next Q1. So you have a Q1 here. Just I'm going to use one AND gate. So I'll get one AND gate. So this is the value what I'm getting as Q1 and X bar. So I'll get here, it is Q1 X bar. Okay. Now this is over. Next you have a, you can use a 3 input AND gate. So in the lab, it is not possible to use a 3 input AND gate. So when come to Dual Sim Simulator, you have an option, but I'll explain 2 input AND gate now. How? if I'm going to use a two input AND gate, then what I'm going to do, just first do these two connections, Qn bar and EX. Later, the output of this one, you can join with the Q2, then I'll get the second circuit. Okay, first you need to do the Q1 bar X, means this is my Q1 bar, then you can consider here, and X you have here, just take this line, and you can do the connections. So you just, both you connect with an AND gate. So once you did this connection, I'll get the output here. So Q1 bar, so I'll get the value is Q1 bar and X. So once you got, then you just check it out. Again, Q2 should, you need to connect here. So Q1 bar X, you have to one AND gate, then you need to connect with the Q2. So where is my Q2? Just take it from here. This is my Q2. Just connect it to here, and this is my Q2. You can use one AND gate for this. So then this is the output what I am getting. This complete output, Q2, Q1 bar X, it is the output. Here it is, I'll get the Q2. Okay. So once you got, then relation between these two, you have a one OR gate. Then you can connect one OR gate now. So just I'm going to use one OR gate. So just use one OR gate. And you can connect it to D2. So you can use one OR gate and connect it to my D2. Okay. So this is my D2. And previously we discussed about D1. Next, how to, I want to connect my Y also. Y is nothing but Q2 and Q1. So in order to connect this, so just take one line from Q1. Yeah, I'm going to take it from here. This is Q1. Next, I'll use a Q2 here. Just I'll use one AND gate. And I'm getting my output. So output here, I'm going to take an as Y. So this is my Y. So this is a circuit diagram of sequence detector of 101. So we'll see that complete circuit diagram. So this is a circuit diagram what I am getting, and what is the IC we are going to use for this construction. So we need to design, right? Now to design this one, we are going to take one IC. That IC, it is IC7474. You can see that this is IC7474 what I am going to use. Here pin number 1, it is a clear one. Pin number 2, it is D1. 3, it is a clock 1 bar. 4, it is preset 1. 5, it is Q1, 6, it is Q1 bar, 7, it is ground. Similarly, 14, it is a VCC, clear 2, D2, clock 2, preset 2, Q2 and Q2 bar. What it indicates, so if I'm looking for my 7474 IC, internally you have a 2 D flip-flops. So we have a 2 D flip-flop, and pin number 14, it is a VCC, and pin number 7, it is a ground. I'm going to use, and in my structure of sequence detector of 101 also it's require a 2D flip-flop, then I'm going to use this one IC to construct my sequence detector. Okay, this is the one thing, and second thing, it is in my circuit I have a NOT gate also. So NOT gate means what is the IC we're going to use, that is IC7404. So only one gate I'm going to use, that is once I'm looking for IC7404, internally having a 6 gates, out of that I'm going to use one gate. Out of that, pin number 1, it is the input, 2, it is the output. Okay. Similarly, here we have a 4 gates, AND gates. You can see that 1, this is first AND gate, this is second AND gate, this is the third, and this is a fourth AND gate. For that case, we are going to use the AND gate IC, that is 7408. Once I am looking for 7408, internally I have a 4 AND gates. So all 4 AND gates I am going to use here. So I want to represent the pins. Here you should remember, for 7408, if I'm looking for 7408 or 7404, what I'm going to use, and next it is 7432 for OR gate, 7432 for all these three cases. Remember, pin number 14, it is a VCC, and pin number 7, it is a ground. You need to use this. So 14, it's a VCC, 7, it is a ground. You need to connect that. Next, AND gate pins, how will get? 1, 2, 3, it is a output. Similarly, just give 4, 5, 6, it is a output. Similarly, 7, it is a ground. 8, it is a output. You need to write here 8, 9, 10. Next, this is 12, 13. it is 11, it is a output. Okay, after 10, it is 11 at the output, next 12 and 13. So in this way, you need to represent, and you have a one OR gate also, that is 7, 4, 3, 2, only one OR gate I'm going to use, that is 1 and 2, 3. Just do this connection and represent the pin numbers. And next, by seeing this IC, just you write the pin numbers of D1. What is the D1 pin you have? It is pin number 2, and Q1 it is 5, Q1 bar it is 6. You can just check it out. It is 2, 5 and 6. Pin number 3 it is a clock, and pin number 11 it is a clock 2. So I'm going to use. Similarly, 12, 9, you can use here it is. 12 is nothing but you can see here it is D2, and 9 it is Q2, but Q2 bar I'm not going to use. That's why I'm not going to considering here. So Q2 bar I'm not going to use. If you want, you can represent the pin number, it is 8. Okay, so it is normal pins, just represent here. The extra thing, it is two things. One, it is preset and clear, and preset and clear I'm going to use it here. So here, remember what in the IC diagram, we are looking for preset bar and clear bar. So preset bar means, if you clear bar means, if you use 0, then only it will be clear of this IC. So for that, what we are going to do, just my clear and preset, both are connected to VCC. Just see that, where is my preset and clear, just see the pins. So pin number 4 and pin number 1, pin number 13, pin number 10. So all we connected to VCC. Just check it out, 1, 4 and 10 and 13. We are going to connect it to VCC, VCC of what? Plus 5 volts we are going to connect it. Okay, so this is a construction of your sequence detector. We'll see that how to do the in Delsim simulator.